Hello friends, today we will learn how to run periodic tasks in the background in a tkinter ttkbootstrap graphical user interface. Here we have a tkinter GUI. I'll run it. So as you can see, this is our tkinter ttkbootstrap GUI. It uses tkinter, but it also has the ttkbootstrap theme extension, so it looks nice. So we have two text boxes here. These are the scroll text boxes, which are part of the ttkbootstrap. Now, as you can see from the bottom, you can see that there is this particular text box that is continuously updating. That is done by using the background task function of the tkinter GUI. For that, we are using something called as the dot after method, or the root or the window dot after method, which is used to continuously update a value. As you can see from here, you are reading from a dummy sensor. I mean, there is no sensor. We are just giving a random number, which is been incremented by the background processor, and it is used to, and it's displayed on the second text box. Now, at the same time, we can also use the other text box, this one. So if I press these buttons, it will display a text on the this particular text box. So it won't result in freezing of GUI or something like that. I will show you. So you can see, so when I press the button one, it will display some text here, like button one, like that. And if I press button two, it will show the other thing. At the same time, you can see that the lower part of the text box, which is a separate text box, is continuously updating. There is no freezing or something like that. This is done by using the dot after method of the tkinter GUI. Now I'll teach you how to code this particular software. This is useful if you are building some graphical user interface for a sensor or something like that, where you have to control the sensor and then you also have to display the values continuously on the screen. So first we will go for a rather simplified option. So instead of going for all this GUI, I will show you a very simple method to do the same thing. And one more thing, we have to install that ttkbootstrap, this one, theme extension using the pip installer. So if you have not done it, you have to do it, otherwise there will be some errors. Now this is a rather simple tkinter program, and here I will demonstrate how to use the dot after method. Now first we import the ttkbootstrap library as ttkb, and then we'll create a small window, root equal to ttk window, theme name anything that you want. If you're not familiar with that theme, you can do check out our tkinter tutorial. So I'll put that in the description also. So here we will also specify the size of the window, which is 800x500. And there is this particular update function. And then we have the root.main loop. This is part of the graphical user interface loop. Now I'll run this thing. Now it will just create a window. At the same time, you can see that in the command line, a hello is being printed again and again. This is done by the background task. Now that particular function, that is the function that is running the background hello, is this one. This is called the update underscore function. So I will go to the function body, which is here. This is the function body where we will be using the dot after method. So this is the update function, and we have the method that is known as the root.after. Here root should be the name of that window. Here we are calling that ttk.window equal to root. So we have to use the root.after. If you have changed the name of the root to something else, like root2 or something, then you have to give the, this also should be root2. So like that. So it is saying that we have to run a particular function. Here the name of the function is update underscore function every 1000 milliseconds. So if you give 1000 here, it will call this function after every 1000 milliseconds, that is nanosecond. So when you call the function for the first time, it will go here, it will print this particular function, then it will come here. And after 100 milliseconds, it will call this particular function, update underscore function, again, it will print again, and like that, it will continuously print the update function. So you'll be just printing hello because we have disabled the count. So this is how the update function works. So you can put any function here actually. Instead of printing, you can put some read a sensor from the serial port, or update a graph like the pyplot graphic plotting library. Like that, you can draw a animated graph if you put it here. So now I'm going to give a count. First, we define a count equal to 0. And we are telling the function that we'll be using the global count, not the local count. So we have to give this global count. Then we'll print the count here along with the hello. Then we will increment the count here. We'll go here. And after 100 milliseconds, it will come here. It will do the same thing again. Since count is a global variable, it will be continuously incremented instead of getting reset. So this is how it's done. Now, if you reduce it, it will run very fast because we are calling it at 100 milliseconds. So I'll run it once more. Like this. You can see it here. Now this is, I'm creating the window, but I'm displaying all these things inside the command line. So I will teach you how to build a graphical user interface in which this particular method is used to update the window. So we'll be using the scroll textbook. So we need to import the necessary constants and libraries. So that's this line doing here from ttkbootstrap.scrolled. We'll be importing the scroll text. Now we are also using the count here, same thing. Now as usual, we'll be creating the root equal to ttk window. Then we will define the size of the window, root.geometry, 600 into 500. Then we'll give a title that will be running periodic background tasks in the ttkbootstrap/tkinter. We'll create a text box. So this is the button_text. So this is to display whatever the button does. All the button actions will be displayed in this particular text box. So this is the one actually I'm talking about. If I press the button one, so that is this my button_text. So we then pack the button using giving a little padding on the X and Y axis. And you can also change the height and width from here. Then we'll create two buttons. The first one is called button_1, which is a normal TTK button. That's the name of the button is text button1. And it'll call the command, function handler, button_1_handler. And we'll position the button using the pack method. And we'll also give it a small pad on the Y axis. So they will be positioned vertically, one over the other. And we create the second button, which is the button_2. Same thing also, button2 command, it will call another button handler, which is called as the button2 handler. Now we'll create another text box, this one. This is the bottom one, the one that is constantly being showing, this one. So we'll create a scroll text box. So we'll give the width and other things, same as before. And you're doing the packing in the second one. Then we call the update_function. So this is the update_function. Here we will continuously call the, we'll continuously insert that text into the text box. So for that particular one function, we are using the count to increment the value. We also have the background_textbox. That is the name of the bottom text box. We're using the insert one, and we'll insert this particular text. And we'll also display the count here. So that's how it works. Then it will come here and it will call the root.after this particular function after 100 milliseconds. You can change it to 1000. So it will be, the delay will be more. That depends upon your program. If you want to call it more often, use the 100 milliseconds like that. This only takes values in milliseconds, not seconds. That you should remember. So when you run this thing, this will constantly go round and round and will update the text like this one. When you press button one, that's this one. So when you press the button one, this handler get called. and it will insert the you press button 1 text. And when you call button 2, it will insert the button 2 you press button 2 text into the top window, I mean top text box. That would be this one. So this will come here and button 1 and button 2 like that. So this is how this program works. Now I'll show you what this particular line does. First I will comment this particular line out, and then I'll run it again. Now you can see that our background value is being updating, but you can see that the text box is stuck. It's not stuck. It is still inserting the values into the text box, but it is not scrolling the vertical scroll bar. If you scroll it down, you can see that it is being continuously being inserted. So now we want to see this being continuously inserted. We want to see the last value again and again at the bottom of that particular text box. So that is the job of this particular line, background actions dot c tk dot end. It positions the display in such a way that the last line is visible. We are using that here also because we want to see that effect of the text box getting scrolled. So if it is not there, it will look like that the text box is stuck. Like this. You can see that it's stuck, but it is still working. Now I'll put it back again. So you can see this scrolling, right? So that is what that particular function does. So if you like my tutorial, do like and subscribe. You can also check out our website. The code for this is available on our website. The link is in the description. This is our website. You can find all sort of embedded system tutorial and products from our website. We manufacture things like USB to serial converter, USB data acquisition systems, and isolated USB serial, things like this one. So if you are interested, you can check out our store and you can buy these things and help us to support us. So we also have an online tutorial, for example, TTK Bootstrap, this one. So you can check that one if you want to. All the code are available on our website. So the source codes are available here and you can go to our GitHub and download from here. So do check out our website and do check out our online store if you're interested in learning about embedded systems.